okay, so I saw some shit. Okay. You saw your man that do the dancing, little band dude.
Yeah.
So, first of all, I wasn't here for the episode when y'all was here. But I could have clearly understood when I watched it that y'all was telling this man, you and DC, y'all was explaining to this man how the shit wasn't cool. And what did he do with the information? Apparently,
it did not register.
It looked like he shrugged it off.
It did not
register. I didn't want to hear it because he was too busy doing the nasty swizzle or whatever the fuck he was.
Well, they always know the latest songs, though, and use it as they did.
And they change it to a crack smoking song.
Yeah, they always use it.
My beat is bad and boozy. Open up crack with a little oozy. Fuck with me and smoke a crack. Fuck with me and smoke a crack.
You couldn't smoke with me if you
wanted to.
It's fucking amazing out of all the titties. The titty that wish to get what some shit with fat titty be out, they don't even try to come out. I'm like, this titty right here, that's like a titty that went to college.
It won't be here.
Because the titty is aware, hey, we out in public. It's up to me to just stay right here. Let's be on our best. Never do that.
This episode show much love to all the women out there who appreciate dicks, big pictures, big shape, ice cubes.
But only if you want it. Only if you ask for it. Don't force this shit. If you sign the UPS form for the payment.
Consensual. Let them see the crumbs, man. We in the corner, right? Crumbs in the bit, bro. The city came out.
We wouldn't have it any other way.
We wouldn't.
We couldn't.
I just want that kid to start playing.
I've been out here for a minute. I don't give a damn about it. Give me some barbecue eggs and give me one of them sweet hot pickles.
Donald Duck, this motherfucker got PTSD.
Hey, what's up, man? Mental health is a real issue, which is not often discussed in our community. Post-traumatic stress, depression, all types of things could possibly be going on. You might want some insight that you can't get from your family and friends. I would like to introduce you to the professionals over at TalkSpace.com. Yes, TalkSpace.com is a virtual therapist that you can vent to about work, family, friends, relationships. You may just want to talk to somebody who's licensed in the medical field who can help guide you into some of these, you know, with some of these issues that you may or may not be having. So I would like to invite you to talk to the professionals at www.talkspace.com. Use my code SOUTH, that is www.talkspace.com/South. Using TalkSpace, you can connect with your therapist online, video chat, text, email. www.talkspace.com/South. Use my code so you can receive $30 off your first month subscription. Yes.
He just posted that on there.
What are you doing?
I was in there,
man, was that a real picture they put up on? That shit
was
real.
That shit was like, I'm good.
Oh, well, that was, oh, that was,
bro, that shit is a class. I got that shit on my iTunes.
You know how you
do it?
Bro,
that was a sad nigga anthem.
You know, that all originated from the man Marvin Peace.
You already know that.
You know, Marvin Peace is probably about, you know,
yeah, you know.
Jody. Nigga, what
it really go back before.
Look, he told him to lift you up.
Howlin' Wolf got a song called Back Door Man. Howlin' Wolf. It's that shit right here. Yeah. Bad niggas all over the place,
but but that's true. It
it's a movement.
It is definitely well.
Nothing new. Bro, from what I heard, that ain't even the same moon that was up there when we was little boys. Bro, I've been following B.O.B. on Instagram. This nigga got my question about everything. You see this shit we got on the table today? We got some new shit.
Motel.
I got my big rocket. Okay, you know.
Hold it up. Who folded these so nice?
My nigga, real. Not only is the nigga a great animator, he has great shirt folding skills. Yeah. Broke clips and chill. That shit's fresh. That shit's so fresh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Big the double on eyes with that.
Come on, bro.
The double on eyes with that's my thing.
Come on, bro.
I know what the word is. It's double on eyes with that.
Yeah.
Sometimes you just say it.
But you your auntie's favorite nephew.
Double on eyes with
that. Bro, and this one right here, so us, you got to see the whole shit. That's this thing. Like the trees, bro.
Yeah. That's a real bud.
Come on, man.
Come on. That to school kids.
Y'all need to make sure y'all support the 85,000. But we just flexing, you know what I mean? Off-white Jordan 1.
Come on, man, plug.
Shout out to the plug. Oh, my God. I only wanted to put these up here because I don't know what they're
going to do. The plug.
Yeah.
They got it.
Yeah. But I will.
They got it.
They do, but they don't. You know what I mean?
Does that make sense?
They do. They don't, but they do.
Right.
Yeah. All kinds of shit. I like these because they fucked up.
But they win.
Like, I don't even know what this shit do, but it's fresh. Who would have ever thought?
Yeah. Come on, man. You know who though? That's your boy Virgil, right?
What I don't know. I stopped researching this shit. I just grabbed him.
He fucked with Yeezy. He was helping him design. Do the Virgil album. I was like, that's his boy.
Who would have ever thought?
Check it.
He just simplifies shit to make people go crazy.
Right.
He basically labeled all the parts of the shoe and said,
no, I didn't know information. I grabbed the information. I hold on to it.
That's what he's known for. He's an information rapper.
You understand?
Take his words.
No, it's right. That's right.
No. You shouldn't. Because this nigga knows.
Are you taking that B12 like I told you?
Yeah. See? This nigga put you up on the potassium game.
Yeah, I knew you. I knew I should.
You should have.
These kind of talks is black men we need to be having. Yeah, they say we dying off early and sick as we end up on the potassium.
Potassium?
Yeah. Potassium. Come on, bro. Black men need to know the importance of zinc.
Zinc?
Yeah, bro.
Zinc.
Yeah. Vitamin A is a motherfucker too.
You need vitamin A?
Come on, bro.
The vitamin C?
Woo!
Come on, man. Everybody love vitamin C.
Oh, look, what's my
head? That's why all these niggas catching colds, man.
Yeah.
They don't drink
oranges. Come on, bro.
Y'all stop drinking. See the oranges over there. Is it?
Come on,
tell me. Oranges promote mucus.
Come on, bro.
You understand what I'm saying? Here you go. When you drink the orange juice right and you go to spit it, don't it be stringy and extra?
That's because you got the pump in
you. Mucus, bro.
Right.
Pump free.
Yeah. The other way to get vitamin C, orange juice right for you is too much acid.
Come on,
man. You ain't balanced.
Come on, take some vitamin C.
Are you telling me my grandma was wrong?
You
That nigga who ran the first.
So, and everybody who ever had a Lumina can laugh at this, and people that still have a Lumina, they know they need
to. You know who drives Lumina?
The third car is not on the road no more.
Hey, the only motherfucker, riding around in Chevy Lumina right now are running for sheriff. This nigga wanna be the sheriff, bad as a motherfucker.
Hey, that used to be the jump out boy car too, didn't it?
The Lumina.
The escort and the but what was the Chevy one? They had a Chevy one.
The jump out Chevy, it was the photo of Lumina with the dark tint. That just looked like a pregnant.
You know what that is? What? Like the bubble. Like you knew all the bubbles in your hood. Like, you know what I'm saying? When that shit came through with no hubcaps, you knew that wasn't no, you know what I'm saying?
The brakes let you know. The brakes let you know, too.
Your hard-ass brakes.
Police coming to the hood looking for drugs. They would have never been there if you wouldn't have brought them over there.
You brought them,
motherfucker.
Shout out to the Red Dog Police Department.
No, shout out to them, motherfucker.
And then sell the shit back. Like, you ain't know where the drugs coming from.
Set all my niggas up, man.
You know what's crazy, though?
Actually, we be on here talking a whole lot of shit just fucking around, but the police, actually, some police officers, hold on, let me stop saying police, one of these police officers contacted somebody that I know via direct message on Instagram, and he's like, man, I listen to the 85 South Show in the patrol car every day at work. I was like, bruh. I did not know that, that we had to get the officers to say that.
No, this is what we do it for. We can touch one, if we want to teach one.
Right. So just by saying that message, you don't need, maybe he can let somebody go because he laughed. That's the shit on
you. You know what? You know what I found?
Somebody just let a nigga slide by that time. He forgot what it was. He was going to give him a ticket, but he forgot how fast they were going.
Don't he do it? So, look, I found out a dude, I'm not going to say their name.
Don't say their name. I was trying to keep that out of
my name. But it was a white dude. They do comedy, but they was an officer in Cloud County. By the time I was out in Cloud County, and he said his girlfriend used to smoke. And he would have never been taking nobody to the police.
Why?
He looked different now, but I don't know if he might
have let me got this. But Kyle County don't let nobody slide. I never seen that. Don't let nobody slide.
Yeah, right. Kyle County, they will too. Georgia having a contest for who can be the most ruthless police. They had some lawsuits, and motherfuckers, they discriminate for now. Like, they really indiscriminate. Yeah. You going.
Now, see, it's fucked up, but that's the type of police work I can respect. Get, take everybody to the goddamn jail.
Don't do no fake jobs.
Take everybody.
This is what I'm saying. Matter of fact, speaking of this thing.
Go ahead.
Can we, are we starting or
this is
three cars?
This is our
three cars. This is the show.
Before.
The last show.
The three cars.
This is the, we on this half of the flag.
Take your thesis.
I'm just saying, we
don't need to have anything.
You're still opening arguments. Yeah, okay. So, I saw some shit.
Okay.
You saw your man, the dude dancing, little Dan dude.
Yeah.
So, first of all, I wasn't here for an episode of reality. Right. But I could have clearly understood when I watched it that y'all was telling this man, you and DC, y'all was explaining to this man how the shit wasn't. And what did he do with the information? Well, apparently,
it did not register.
It looked like he scrubbed it off.
He did not
want to hear it because he was too busy doing the nasty swiggle or whatever the fuck he was doing. You know, I don't know if that's even his beard. I saw beard with
him. See, this is the thing.
You can tell he's patchy.
I didn't know he was white.
Okay. Until he was, I thought he was. Is this nigga playing?
So, okay.
Or is he not this nigga? Who is he? I don't know.
So,
I don't want that to be like, I scared the shit on me. We did not
condone that, but
exactly. So, I gathered that.
Right.
I gathered that. Like, for you, it was like, oh, who the fuck are you right now? And then,
look, I'm looking like,
oh, no, I saw.
Thank you.
I saw. So, then y'all proceeded, if DC told this ain't what you do, this word. tell you what he's got me. Because I'm remembering correctly.
You are.
I'll go back and fucking check. Whatever. But so, you come on here, first of all, man, like,
you should have been here.
No, no, I'm
going to start FaceTiming you in, bro. It's waves around this shit. You think I can't pull you up on that Lex Luthor screen? You be sitting up to a conference table? I like this. Get back to the stuff you were discussing previously. We will do this. We have technology.
Okay, so my thing is this, bro. Motherfuckers from here from the camp told you. So now your apology is No. Motherfuckers been trying to tell you. Now that shit is dipped in your fucking pocket.
Right.
You don't. Oh, no, I'm sorry. No. First of all, this is how I'm feeling. Black people, stop fucking giving people a pass so fucking easy.
Mm-hmm.
Stop giving white people a pass because they did a dance. They made a song. Oh, I'm looking at you, too.
What
the fuck are you going to talk about?
No, you don't listen to Post Malone.
First of all, I'm going to tell you the play. What they do, they jumped in. Oh, I'm cool with the black people because I know how to dance.
They do it.
Everybody do it. Who didn't do it? Justin Timberlake and Dilly.
Oh, he did it. Robin Thicke came over here and stole all Marvin Gaye music.
I know
that. He didn't rock.
But Pete Boone did that shit.
I didn't even know that.
Pete Boone was a man in black. I thought he fought aliens. And I never liked the DJ thing. First of all, that's the DJ shit from New Orleans. I don't know that DJ's name. I can't think of his name, but that's his shit. And y'all took it and ran with it, and y'all might have pulled it. No, the dude that do it ain't no DJ, but the way he talking, that's one of them DJ from New Orleans. So your whole shit is manufactured. You know what I'm saying? So, I don't know, man. Y'all hold hands and figure that shit out, man.
That's how you feel.
I don't know. I'm just saying, stop giving me motherfuckers pass. They don't get no passes. They don't give nobody no passes. I don't want no white friends that don't act white.
Hey, so what?
I don't want no white friends that don't act white. I don't want no white friends that don't act white.
Paul Wall ain't fucking.
No, Paul Wall. Look, here's the thing, though, right? Paul Wall ain't never. I ain't heard him say, nigga. Nigga, we watch Power every week. Tommy Game says, nigga, this nigga guy goes back like a motherfucker. I've yet to hear him say, nigga. So, it's nothing to do with motherfuckers who's genuine. It's from some other shit because you want to.
Don't nobody, yeah, that's what you say. Ain't no, they don't give a fuck how genuine you are.
How you meant it. You just, that's no.
No.
The people we rock with, the real, like, straight up, I've been around people. I was around this white stripper one time. She was saying, nigga, baby. I said, hey, you can't be saying that. Take it in. Take what the fuck I'm saying, man. Like, and this is from a fucking stripper. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Who? Well, that just might have been her way to make sure I still tip her. Like,
yeah.
This is, you know, I'm not making it. Like, this is, you know, I'm not saying it. Means to a motherfucking.
What did the brother say to him about saying this?
No. He said from the video I saw, he said he called him a nigga because he said cracker, and he called me a cracker so I could say nigga. But he told him to call him a cracker.
Found the MG. He tried. He got out of New Orleans.
Son, he never apologized for
it. Then I owe you an apology.
Son, you do so much shit that you don't apologize for.
Who?
Like what, Ash? Name some stupid ass.
I'm a.
Name one.
You say the N-word. You say the N-word.
So?
Alright. You say.
You say cracker.
When?
Say cracker.
Why would I say it? Why would I not say it? Why would I say it?
Wait, no, wait. Cracker.
Now say the N-word.
Say
the N-word so I can post it. Alright, it's on YouTube. I want your consent on camera.
The thing is, I want your consent on camera.
You got a fucking problem because you just said cracker, so I can say nigga.
No. Say that I can post this. Say it. Say I want you to say it on camera.
Son, post it. You all stupid. Right. All right.
Dumbass. Y'all seen it.
Now why? I was on the 85 South show. Got millions of views. Said nigga all over.
Well, I thought you had a gun.
I mean, that's perfectly fine.
Because you trying to put me in a position where you can say cracker and I couldn't say.
Wait, let me tell you how stupid.
No, you just shut the
fuck up. Shit comes reactionary. Right. You might not know you racist, but if you say some shit as a reaction,
that man,
you fucking racist.
You that man.
If people watching that, they think that's cool now that you had white fans. Now they gonna play around with their black fans. Right. Now it look like it's cool.
But everybody has a play.
I feel like everybody
got that. They think that they gonna get that one chance to say it. Like, oh, my bad.
We cool though. We cool. You don't get to do that.
He threw the shit in there. Like, 85, but I said it on there.
No. They try to make it seem like we was with the shit.
Like, no. Passes was just.
If it wouldn't have been that attached to it, I wouldn't have never said so. Oh, like, that ain't got shit to do with me.
Right.
But then you tried to make it seem like he was with
you. Yeah, like everybody, like you just be around people saying.
You know what I'm saying? And that's the shit. He said what he wanted to say. Just like everybody had to say whatever the fuck they want to say. But if you say some shit, you gonna have to hold up for what the fuck you said.
I don't want no motherfucker looking at me like, hey, Colin, no, everybody, this motherfucker grown.
Whatever happened on this business is because you said it. Whatever it is, you want to sit back and bullshit and play with the comedians? All right, we'll play how we play then.
He never was talking. He was getting bands in the first
place. But
now,
I thought he was a...
That's crazy. That's
crazy. He was holding it in all the time.
Bro.
Look. When I first saw him, I thought he was a mime.
The first time I was like this nigga here. And then people see it, and you giving them access to what you see.
Damn,
bro. Right. And you don't know if I just motherfucker think, man, come on, let's not act like, y'all don't act like, oh, somebody ain't raised, they think black people are.
Hey, you've
been trying to look at all
women. You've seen all these stories trending on social media where people are like, oh, went to my white girlfriend's family house. But one of these football player niggas went over to his wife's family house and they called him a nigga and he posted this shit on social media. I don't know, man.
No, that's for him to do with. You go over there. If you've been called a nigga in here by a white person, please.
What?
Like one time or like a lot?
That's the answer a lot.
But there's a room for the black men, though. Everybody that called us niggas, little kids, white women, old people.
So that's what I'm saying.
Puerto Ricans.
So he acted, he want to come on social media. And how do we deal with it? Do you want people to give you attention? No, you should have known this.
That's what the whole point of this movie Get Out was. When you put yourself over there in that space, you got to deal with all that shit. You think everybody fuck with you? All these white people at this party, you think everybody like you?
You gonna find out.
Man, you crazy as a motherfucker.
You know, one that like you that wants your body for
goddamn research purposes and to integrate.
We got a doorbell now?
Yeah.
See what's up.
What did he do?
That might be my home girl, I think.
Yep, that's her.
Yep, that's her.
I didn't know he tried to use
85. No, that's what I don't like. That's that shit I don't like. What else, bro? This is a great moment we in right
now. I don't know.
What you beefing about, man? What's on your chest?
No, it's good.
No,
giving people
pads
and think that they do some shit mildly cool.
Oh, yeah.
Welcome back to the 85 South Show. This is your man, Carlos Miller.
God damn. That was a weak ass clap.
Come on, man.
And we got to add some more claps on the post. Y'all love what we got to call them post production.
Right.
Welcome back to the 85 South Show. This is your man, Carlos Miller. Back in this bitch, like I forgot my keys. I got my home girl. Stop it. The new room, man.
The party in the after party. I got my motherfucking little cousin, favorite comedian, baby daddy in this motherfucker. My nigga Nav Green.
Man, what's going on?
What's happening? Did I get him
too much?
The only nigga that ever fought with you like that. Hey, bro. Damn, I'm tying up on here, bro. I ain't even gonna keep telling y'all who this nigga, because we just call him Rambo. Rambo with his motherfucker with us.
Yeah.
I just did that for so y'all can ask to know.
That was good.
Yeah. Hey, bro. Super Christmas tree over here, bro.
Well,
no. Bro, you are not my Christmas tree over, bro. Hey, Joe, let them see the crumbs, man. We in the front of the right crumbs in these bitch, bro. You know what I'm saying? Storm is crumbs. Storm is crumbs tree. What's up, man? You see the crumbs tree in these bitch? It's crumbs time. Who that?
Boopop.
Oh, okay. Who that behind you?
What up?
Them your people? Yeah, I bet. Y'all pull up with us. You know, get in here. We just 85 stopping it right now. You know what I'm saying? Telling these people about Roach, Cliff, and Till.
We back, man.
We back.
We good.
How y'all feeling?
I'm feeling good.
Yeah. Bro, you was deep. You jumped off in this. Oh, you jumped off.
No, that was.
We needed that thing.
That was that. Yeah. We got to
but she's so real.
You know what I heard? I ain't making a statement.
She's so real.
It's really about me making a statement.
She's so real.
Hey, I was there. It was me. And Clayton, he pulled his dick out. Did I pull it out?
Did you?
I may have.
Oh, wow.
But if you said put your dick up, I definitely put it up.
Wow. So you said, is that your way of saying that it might be some allegations coming
out? No, ain't no fucking
you're leading to it. That's called leading.
No. It's not leading.
You ain't heard?
So,
you're my partner, but I ain't know you the type of nigga.
Well, it's time to move fast.
Right.
Be real. So, you say that we don't pull our dicks out? Dicks don't get pulled out of here, man? You with a nice young lady, and she seems like she's vibing a little bit, she do, and you just shoot your shot with your dick. Hey, that's not what we doing, and she tuck your dick back in.
Wow. You know who we, you just reminded me that we must, this episode, show much love to all the women out there who appreciate dick, dick pictures, dick shape, ice cubes.
But only if you ask for it, only if you ask for it, only if you sign the UPS form for the payment.
Consensual. Yeah. Ladies who appreciate the dick that they ask for.
You can't even send a diamond no more. You gotta send a text.
Nope.
I might about to send you a dick pic. Is it cool?
I didn't know that you was don't reference that. Don't.
Well, can I send you something?
You gotta let her lead into that.
Like what the fuck you? I don't know.
So you said you stuck and you don't know when to do it. Talk to him, Clay.
You do a text, you say pick one.
Pick a ball.
Oh wow. And then if you don't need it, then you just play on me. You're like, what if I send you a picture of my name?
Man.
You know what I'm saying? You can't
I don't know. Don't do that. Don't do that. Dick pictures last forever.
Oh, so you say do a photo shoot with your dick?
I'm telling you, bro.
This motherfucker out here, he put makeup on his dick.
I'm not sending no dick pictures, man. We live in the technology age.
Yeah,
she likes your dick. Why she happy with you? But let her break up with your ass and get mad. These bitches are photoshopped your dick. Has your dick looking like a pinky toe.
What if you FaceTime?
Look at this nigga dick.
I don't like it. What the fuck is that?
This bitch gonna put a smiley face on your dick Actually, she just photoshopped the whole dick off. You got a vagina. She just put a whole pussy on there.
What is
she
doing?
She just skin tone matched you to somebody who looks just like you.
She took a picture of
me. Mm-mm.
You FaceTime, it's all right.
I suggest niggas go back to the 80s, bro. You just gonna have to show the dick in person. Don't be sending no goddamn high resolution.
Bro. Out, man.
And I'm gonna say this too. Let's not stop. Like, white dudes been acting weird. Don't try to act like they just been. White dudes do fucked up shit to other white dudes.
You know what's so
funny? You go to sleep with their partner, they're gonna draw little dicks on your chest.
They actually gonna put
it. No, they gonna put their dick on you and face it with a fabric.
This is my real pack, bro.
No, they're gonna put a lamp in your ass, turn it right on. They call it a gun and shit on
you. So basically, you saying.
We drink it to tampons.
So you saying white dudes been sexually harassing everybody.
What are you talking about?
Come on.
Come on, man. Who we name? Sean Dusty. Woody Allen.
Ron Mark, what's his name? NBC Mario.
Kevin Spacey. Talk about.
I was acting out of character.
No, that's your kid.
You like to fuck boys.
Kevin Spacey tried to avoid his accusations.
No,
that nigga just said, I'm gay. Fuck it. Whatever they said, I did. I'm just gay.
That
nigga
was going to catch him.
Exactly.
He tried to jump out like, but I'm gay. And then he's like,
dude.
No, we can't.
This is fucked up.
You fuck little boy.
There is some shit going on.
They did not catch him.
No, they did not.
Nothing.
Nothing.
And then you hear the stories, like they're going in graphic details of like what the fuck happened. How you just gonna be a like a motherfucking perverted ass?
I'm a compulsive masturbator.
In front of people, looking them in the eye. And this is, and you are known for this.
I'm Steve. I work in HR.
Have you seen that thing that Steve does?
You mean the thing?
Yeah, the thing.
Has he done it to you?
Yeah.
When did you do it?
Tuesday, it's Monday.
What the fuck, man? Everybody in the office noticed this month. He's talking about the front of the
right?
The computer lady. Motherfucker's driving on paper. This nigga just masturbated in front of whoever fucked for 3 seconds.
This is crazy.
Wait.
How much
trouble
are we gonna get into talking about this?
No, it's a winning time. We don't care. We can say what we want.
Man, fuck this shit. Hold on. This how freaky these motherfuckers are. This nigga Al Frank is so freaky. He fitted on a bitch titties through a flag jacket. This bitch basically got on a bulletproof vest, and you playing nipples on it. Come on, man. You gonna play nipples on a bulletproof vest? You wasted your sexual harassment. You didn't even touch the real thing. You touched the bullet. You made nipple prints on a bulletproof vest. Now you a freak. You got to quit the job, all this shit.
He could beat that charge, right?
No, the fuck he could. No. Nobody beat none of these charges.
If he got on the
no, no, no. This nigga took a picture in front of some titties. He's a freak.
Oh, yeah.
Bruh, this shit getting out of control. Okay. Everybody did some shit.
Okay,
and I don't excuse it. They got motherfuckers coming out from the 80s.
I was the waitress at Patty Hollywood. All the sports nigga turned around and his nose hit my titty.
What?
What?
Hey, I'm just gonna say my nose is hit.
What the fuck?
He tried to fall in titty. Nose first, like kid and play.
That's how you know Barack Obama stayed on his shit, because ain't nothing came out yet. This is the time, this is allegation season.
Barack Obama.
Like, that's what it's called.
Because Barack used to talk his way.
I'm going to cut the breath right now.
I'm going to take my dick up.
Yeah, he bent down.
Right.
Because he was really a lame, though. He was a lame, and then she made him who he is.
He was, oh, that's what you said.
Yeah, Barack wasn't cool back then. He was hanging out wearing hats from like a fucking Mexican and smoking weed on the pigeon. He met motherfucking Michelle. He started wearing khaki that fit, started believing in himself.
Come Michelle got real.
Hell yeah. He
didn't come around that
exactly. She had braces way back in the 80s. So you know they had money. Michelle Obama had
he saw the pigeon.
Yeah, she had money.
Man.
You had to have insurance to do that shit back in the day.
Bro.
You know that uncle that sit on the porch and just drink? Yeah, who did that?
You see what's happening? Barack Obama was so professional. He was such a great president. And now he's like, he did all that shit. He was A1. Now his daughter ratchet is here. She's smoking blunts on Snapchat and everything. Hell yeah. She blowing smoke all on Secret Service.
She was in college like,
That motherfucker got a trap history, baby.
Frozen nipple cocaine?
I don't know, Proswell. Niggas don't even know that was his name.
Proswell.
Yeah. John Forte had that DMX shit. He was out there with
him. He got caught.
But white people got some dope out here that niggas don't know nothing about. White people got some shit out here that don't make you happy to go to sleep. Shit kick in when you've been asleep for 4 hours and your dreams turn into a video game. Exactly. Man, they got all kinds of shit out here. White people got some ecstasy. That's the pure ecstasy. That's the shit that they make the ecstasy from. You take this shit, and nothing happened, but you just feel your eyelashes and you have dreams about grandparents and ancestors that you've never even seen before. Get on fucking Google and look up what white people are out here getting out of.
DMT.
Come on. See? Just initials.
No, that DMT, that's where they take the whole trip and figure it out.
Yep.
Deathstroke cut more than a little time.
Most
of the drive.
So crazy.
I had surgery. I didn't even take my Percocet.
You an asshole. Most of us out here dying for Percocet.
This is the thing I want. If the youth that's taking all these drugs, and you take a Xanax, you take a Percocet, you take a Roxy, you take a Oxy, you do it. All this shit, you're doing it simultaneously. Please explain to me what this shit feel like. Because I need all the drugs I'm going to do. So tell me what it feel like so I know what the fuck is in it.
I don't understand how they know you take 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 Xanax a day. One of them motherfuckers will make you pass out and wake up the next day.
That's what it do.
Xanax. I don't know what Xanax do. Every time I ever took a Xanax, all I remember is waking up. I don't know what happened.
So you basically roofied yourself.
Nigga.
You know they tried to roofie me one time.
Who was they?
Man, I was out there.
Who the fuck is they? So we could not be around them.
No, so I'm in Tampa, right? I'm in Tampa. I'm kicking it. Draws at the club. They kicking it. Talking about this dude I'm talking to. Him. We kicking it. We can have it.
Fuck the world we live in, bro.
You know, there's other dude come up with like four of them. And it's him. And he's hanging out. He's like, I want to get a drink. Like, what's wrong? I want to leave. So he was buying the drinks for the girls, right? So the one thing that he was like, I don't drink, but I guess he was like, yeah, I was like, I don't drink. Okay, going back.
Bro, I remember that.
I remember people telling me what I did.
And you don't even know what happened. They might have got it for me, but I was doing other drugs. They said they ain't make me sleep.
I stayed up the whole time.
Yo, what up? It's your boy Ray the Roach reporting to you live from the vent. I got my homeboys Roscoe and Rico with me, and this is the Roach Motel Cypher.
Yeah. Roscoe. Roach Mo. Check me out, though. Hey, I know I'm going to heaven if I can smash, nigga. Future said, God blessing all the trap niggas. I don't ball, but got hoes in all kind of flavors. You can have 2K, can't make a better player. I rob people every day, no mask. Song when the lights on, I'm in your trash. I'm in your kitchen licking all your dirty dishes. Grimy little roaches, bitch, you still wanna kick it. I'm like, if that's your best friend, I'm trying to fuck with you. Cause I don't give a damn if that's your real sister. One got a big booty, one a big chest. If you don't touch each other, really ain't incest. Yeah, I'm bugging, I'm a roach, I'm an insect. Disrespectful nigga crawling all on your chick neck. Up next is Rico from Puerto Rico. Hoes call me Roscoe, talk to him, Vato.
Hey, Vato, Vato, we chillin' tunnels like El Chapo. Hector Camacho, spittin' fire like El Diablo. Call me Papo before the mommies to call me Papi. Haters copy, I'm blowin' sticky like Laddy Daddy. Ladies love me, I'm buggin' the way they treat me, though. Stroke one, I had a million babies about a week ago. Pickin' through the trash every night like, what we eatin', though? Keep a couple caterpillar killers, those my people, though. Chop cucaracha, runnin' with my wolves, que te pasa? Forehand slap five, yeah, yeah, yeah. Idol me, a bug moving in the worst way. Stay lying like people with August birthdays. R.P. to my chico who died outside the wall. When they raided the spot, they tried to kill us all. I'ma be the same Rico till I'm gone. When I die, let me get stepped on by Louis Vuitton.
Yo, what about T-Boy one with me? Nobody chill. My flow body more bugs than a windshield. Born and raised in the hood, I live a thug life. You do soft like that ant from A Bug's Life. The ladybugs like, Ray, nobody cool as you. I probably smash more of them than a human do. I know the boy pull chicks like a loose tooth. They draws drop like Bishop off the roof juice. I'm a pimp, me love a hoe, no way. Only roach I ever love laying in your ashtray. I get them new, chop and screw them like a Houston nigga. This ain't Disney, I don't hang with goofy niggas. You a snitch, you a rat, your dog too though. Guess that makes you Mickey and he Pluto. How you duck like Donald when we come through? We the real Looney Tunes, grimy little goony dudes. This ain't Pixar, my whole clique raw. We spit bars, party hard, then we get bras. Human spraying red, always trying to squash a nigga. If you ain't got no haters, you ain't popping, nigga. See, I'm smart as Huey, and I'm cool as Raleigh. Mobbing with some gangster niggas like I'm Luca Brasi. The flow stupid, talking Peter Griffin, Homer Simpson. Welcome to the Roach Motel, ain't no competition.
But this part from here on out is sponsored by Wave Grease. All of them. They didn't send us a check directly, but they got together and put some money together.
If you're Wave Grease and you want some promotion,
yeah.
It'll slip.
I got my own do-rags coming out this summer. They still. Fuck with your boy. You're going to be able to get them on that money. The rest of them, I don't know, but I'm going with silk lining. I'm using what I know about people themselves.
Man, speaking of do-rags, did you see Tyrese up there with Keisha Lance Bobby?
Bro, why the fuck was Tyrese up there?
I don't know, man.
How do you know him?
I wanted to take my vote back when I see Keisha Lance Bobby up there.
Oh, he said,
what are you doing?
John Creek, is that in Atlanta? No.
Ain't that
where he at?
Bro, that nigga's a
fucking
whore.
Oh, bro, we
got it. That nigga's a baby mama, man. Like, he's
wrong with you. We call that nigga a baby mama.
Bro, he's
bro,
a
bro, that's fucked up, because he watched this show, bro.
Tyrese. Appreciate you supporting me. He's a baby mama ass nigga, man.
He can't watch this show. He watched this show, bro.
He wouldn't be doing all that fucking
shit. But he don't watch this show.
He watched this show?
He watched the show, but he criticized it the whole time.
He be sitting there doing Jody. He talks shit about the show with Jody. He be talking shit about it. I know he be
saying it. Look, first of all, if you was watching this, you would know that shit you're doing is super duper fucking shit.
Yeah.
You don't understand what's going on.
You just tell it lie after lie.
And you in the public.
He crying about paying child support. Like, nigga, you ain't the first one to pay child support. Nigga, I pay $380 a month. You didn't hear me crying out one time.
But that's only $13,000.
I know. He can have my little girl for the balance. So he get his girl.
You'll wear a Sailor Rock shirt and tell your little girl to be Sailor.
You got better money. She want this money. I bust a pin right down the middle with it.
No, I don't know. He went on and said he,
that's not his only daughter, though.
Hey, man,
that's
another
daughter. I wish they could get rid of some of these.
I don't know.
I wish the bitches I knew was from somewhere else, so I'd be like, hey, you know she's still here?
You would ask me.
What nigga
would
you
say? All you got to
do is call Trump. Trump will get her ass out of here.
Trump will get
her
ass out of here. He deported me twice already. Because I didn't think he was hearing that Salvador Domingo.
That's Salvador Domingo. He's one bad hombre, isn't he? He's not just against me. We're going to do some things to get him out of here. Some really, really great, magnificent things.
So that's why you
went to LA. He's going to be huge.
That's why I'm in LA, because it's easy to walk back
here. Yeah. He can be Mexican.
Huh?
He can be Mexican.
That's Salvador Domingo. He don't know shit. He's a real fucking hero, man.
I don't know. Can't be finding any time out there. I was nervous really on the edge of the night. I realized it was the first time for a solid 10
minutes. You don't listen to the TV. Oh, man.
Tell him that.
Yeah.
I'm not here with it, bro.
You look how quiet it got. Ooh, this nigga here, he too much. Nah, but bro, you in a real relationship if your girl done seen your dick on soft. Cause that take a whole lot to go through to let her see it. Nigga, she done put the pussy all the way on. You done fell asleep on top of the cover with the soft dick. You can't even move. Fuck it, ain't no secrets in this house. She need to know the real me. Ladies, if you ain't never seen your man dick on soap, y'all not in a real relationship. I hate to be the one to tell you. If you ain't never seen your man dick on soap, catch him in the shower when he come out. Snatch the nigga towel. Watch him turn back into a little boy. Bitch, quit playing so motherfucking mud. Oh, playful ass bitch. You know goddamn, don't be playing so. Give me the goddamn towel.
Hey, I'm a titty lover.
So you just
really don't feel like you need to tattoo nothing on your titty.
You? Wait a minute, what's that?
Let's take Atlanta back, man.
Even little titties, you go examine them, you just like, this nigga loves them all.
I love all of them.
I'm about to say, you're right. I just think Teddy do some amazing shit. You know what? You know what, Teddy? I think is just fucking amazing out of all the Teddy. The Teddy that wish to get with some shit with sad Teddy be out, and they don't even try to come out. I'm like, this Teddy right here, that's like a Teddy that went to college.
It won't be
because the Teddy is aware. Hey, we out in public. It's up to me to just stay right here. Let's be on our best behavior. Because I done seen a hard head to it. She done did everything to keep this kitty in place. She done taped it. She done tucked a little piece of shirt. And then it still came out. Right.
Right. Tight on the shirt.
All that.
Right.
Kitties just fucking, they just do something to my inner workings or something. I find kitties. You know, legends be trying to sneak and hide kitties.
You know when they be pretty.
Try to wear that button up straight. There's titties under them buttons.
And they
set
the titties down like they
moving
coke.
Come on, bro. Titties looking like 2 keys.
That's like 20 keys and titties.
Come on.
I remember S.A. She's on the basketball team,
bro.
I just see them titties.
Yeah, I don't even speak about shit that happened in my adolescence because now that I'm grown, I know that we were set up to fail, bro. You said 8th grade. I thought the 4 motherfuckers I knew in 8th grade were grown woman titties. You wasn't supposed to get them titties about 10th, 11th grade. She had them. That's when we came back from 7th grade. We came back from 7th grade, the girls were fine. We were still little boys. We were still out there. They came back grown, getting their hair done and shit. We just started getting big. They got periods in the 5th grade. They ready for some real dick. They was waiting on us to catch up.
Bitch told me, I don't
hunt
no more.
Come on, hell no.
Mm-mm. When you start mentioning?
Bruh, puberty was very confusing, man. I ain't had no help. I was out here figuring this shit out by myself. Because can't nobody tell you when you're 13. Yeah, that's what's happening. Your body getting ready to fuck something one day. Hey, now I know what to tell my son.
Like, the older you speak it cold.
They need to get rid of that rooster juice. What is rooster juice? I'm gonna tell you like this. You can dig the hole, but you ain't gonna fill it back up. One thing about a hole, once you get in there, stay there.
What the fuck?
Sneezing in the fuzzy cup.
That means eating
fuzzy. Now that I think about it, bro, nobody ever told me to eat pussy. That was just kind of like a decision you're going to have to make when you get to that spot. Like, ain't nobody ever tell you. Eat some pussy now. They was like,
let's be real.
That's on you.
Let's be real back then. They tried to make pussy was not cool for them.
I remember when eating pussy, you was the nastiest nigga in the neighborhood. Don't fuck with me. Eat pussy. Come here. But when you start eating pussy, you want to tell everybody, man, you can eat pussy.
But you can't because you're home.
They're not ready to receive that information.
I didn't get pussy until I started eating pussy. Like, I was getting coochie.
Wow. You can tell when a nigga start getting pussy, because that's when you grow the fuck up. You start doing shit like washing your car inside and out. Yeah, you get up early. The niggas that be at the car wash early, 9 o'clock.
making a lot of noise with all the flow man laid down on the ground. Yeah, that nigga getting pussy. The nigga who just sit up in there and pay $5 and let their goddamn shit pay all up. That nigga be coochie.
But now, Lowe, I do that, but I come out and I spray the tires, though.
You can tell who's getting pussy out here.
I go do it and let them hit it, but then they hand
out. Nah, you in the middle. Uh-huh.
That means you back and forth. You get a mix. You get a vagina, pussy, coochie, and you don't know where you at. You really ain't consistent. It just depends on what you did.
That's
like,
a month. That's
a month. I'm not going to crack in and wash your car in the freezing cold weather.
And with one bottle.
Come on.
Yeah. So there's alcohol. That's what it is. You rub your car.
All these fast ass motherfucking beers. We're glad you bought this shit up because crackheads don't give no motherfucking shit.
They don't get no crack.
All these fast ass buildings and all this shit well put together. Who the fuck you think they are? Crackheads and Mexicans. Nigga, they're not the world.
See, I think that's fucked up that you're going to just say Mexicans, because you're going to think Mexicans represent all the people who speak Spanish. It's a whole bunch of them folks. So just say them folks. The Hispanic people. The Latino population. Okay, now. Crackheads don't need no credit. Bro, it's 2018. How the fuck you still a crackhead, my man?
They dedicated.
If you started smoking crack after the year 2000, you deserve everything life don't give you.
If you start smoking crack after the year 93, you deserve everything.
Come on, bro.
Y'all don't
pay attention, bro. They just got some good crack here. They just came out with different versions.
That 80s crack, that's what you get
addicted
to. This 90s crack, baby.
Bro, this
when you stay up and fuck.
Bro, this new crack, what I heard. I heard the new crack don't even get you high. You ain't got no cigarette to change it with.
I don't even know about
you. Ain't doing a new boy. All crackers got this same boy like that. This is the boy that you get after you start smoking crack.
That really is, man. That's right here.
Why they always know the latest songs though, and use it to they pick. And they change it to a crack smoker song.
Yeah, they always use it.
My bitch is bad and bougie. Open up tight with a little ooh. Hug with me and throw the crack. Hug with me and throw the crack.
You couldn't smoke with me if you wanted to. I smoke crack. This is go in there, give me two fruit juice. I'll be two of them coconut bars in there when you come out of there. The red, white, and yellow coconut bars. They're sitting right over there by the Mexican. Give me two packs of pumpkin seeds. We don't even know the story. I'm getting there. Get me two of them Lucky Charm cereal bars with the milk in the middle. Got the brown milk in the middle. They delicious. Tell him I want a salted biscuit and two bacon eggs out.
Tell him I take the steak and eggs.
When you get in there, tell him.
And a pack of mental.
Tell him to give me two cupfuls of that mashed potato liquid.
They don't want no boiled peanuts?
No, bring me two of them lemon lime, spicy hot peanuts. Big red. Bring me a pink lemonade and bring me a loaf of bread out of that and two of them jumbo from the gutter. Give me a red cream soda. Look, it's a mystery ass here. Go in there and get me a blue Fago pop and a size 8.5 in some of them Timberland Nikes. Look, this is what I need. I need you to get me two of those Coca-Colas and some of that CK1 cologne that they got in that glass jar.
The Coca-Cola with a name on it or just a name?
No, get two of those things.
Hey, you don't have it. You got a bag of
that he ain't supposed to have. Yeah, I want these Kanye West tickets on the radio this morning. Give me $30 for both of them. I want these on the radio. Damn, you dirty. That nigga said Lindsay. Get up. Come on, say Lindsay. Let me do it. I still talk with Lindsay. That's my name. My name is Lindsay with an E, not an A.
Was somebody in your family?
No, that's me. My name is Lindsay. My first name is Lindsay. My mama thought I was going to be a lady.
Thank you,
Lindsay. What? When we had died, Dr. Pepper, in the can, in the can. They blew the top off. I blew the whole top off.
I don't
know. Bring me two of them glass things with the rose in it. I ain't no goddamn Brillo. That's why I told you, brother, that juice is
I'm gonna chew on that crack all day.
Man, y'all need to quit that shit. If you got somebody who in your family on drugs, right by the area that they be in and throw them something, take them a plate.
What can you do?
You can't do nothing. You can't get them out of it? Quit the pain.
Too late.
One thing about crack, you smoke crack until you get finished. Can't nothing stop you. You got to reach. Well, if it's destined for you to smoke 388 rocks, you ain't gonna stop on 387 because that ain't what God
wants.
There it is. I don't know what that terminology is. Nigga, that shit sounds so fucked up. Like, grab me by the ass and won't let go.
That sounds like one of the shit that nightmares is made of.
Nigga, what happened? First of all, they tried to kill me.
Okay,
then I'm gonna make these motherfuckers no coot. They chased me. I turned around, nigga, grab my ass. I couldn't get him off. No, they ain't fucking me. It just wouldn't let me out of here. I turned around fast enough. But had it been any worse, you asked me, I fought him off. I kept him on the gym. This nigga crip was amazing. I drugged the nigga 33 blocks.
Well, I hit the motherfucker on to my head.
Not his ass out, but that just loosened up the grip.
Oh, he got a hook to my head when they say a hook.
A mechanical hand.
Bro, you're stupid for that.
Hey, this
podcast
right here.
They taking it one day at a time, they
going to
relapse.
Bro, how the fuck else can you take it? I hate when motherfuckers say that. I'm taking it one day at a time. Like, this motherfucker's out here living 3 days at once. Why are you sitting there?
Hey, man, what you doing? Nigga, what are you doing? My head, don't say shit to me.
You got on so many outfits. Bitch ass nigga living one day at a time, nigga.
Nigga, I'm going weak. I heard you clowning 3 weeks
ago. I'm in February. What are you talking about? This nigga got on 3 dragon suits. Both of them unzipped a little bit so you can see that it's all 3 of them.
Andre 50,000.
Come on, man.
My brother take that to the front of me.
Who jumping in there? What nigga jumping on the top of the steps?
One shoe at a time.
I want to meet the motherfucker who
went there.
Right. Put your best foot forward. I want to meet the motherfucker putting his worst foot forward. Nope, hit him with the left. This nigga walking sideways, just inching down the hallway. Come on, man.
What's that one guy getting on the report?
That motherfucker used to hit you with your motherfucker. It's crazy when they make fun of their bitch. I want to rock right now.
I smoke a rock with you.
Oh,
You ever heard a crackhead tell you how he first started smoking? It's always a story about, yeah, I just did good.
Yeah, we'll do a snack.
I don't have the time.
Yeah. Small break.